Thank you for the invitation. I am very happy to be in this situation to explain the French football and the evolution during the last 45 years. And we built a strong football from the bottom. And we decide in the period in 1970 to change and to create really a school professional, it's academy, for to be after professional football. In each job, we need always to have the professional school. And we decide to create the academy and all the club professionals, they must have the academy professional. That is was in 40 years ago with age between 16 years old and 19 and for 3 years and to mix the school, the football and the competition during 3 years and to prepare the career to be after professional. That was the first step we did now a long time ago. And why we did this for two great reasons. First, our result for with the national team was so weak in front of the big, big country of the football like England, Spain, and Italy. And the second, we are in the French country where the taxes are very expensive. And for the club, it's very difficult to keep the best players and the right salary, it's impossible to maintain. That it was two ways for the players. And after, it's important to learn all the things to prepare for the career and to be professional. It's a job, it's a difficult job, it's a high level job. And we need to have the special player very well prepared with a very good coaches for the academy, totally different for the coach of the first team. Why is different? It's different because when you prepare the players, in 3 years, your target is to prepare the players to play in professional team. It's not to win the game the Sunday. It's a totally an option. And the most important people they work in the academy are special coach for those young players. They know everything of this category. That was the big step 40 years ago. But after the good success we have had in 82 and 86 and 84 when we won the European Cup with the national team and we did 82 and 86 two semi-finals in World Cup in Spain and in Mexico. And we decided to create from Clairefontaine. Clairefontaine was created really in 1988. It was created in center close to Paris, 60 kilometers from Paris in the big forest, in the beautiful castle, many pictures, many buildings for the young boy, for the national team, for the course of the coaches. And we decided in this period to change the methodology and to increase the good methodology, not from 16 years old, from 13 years old. And we decided to create one group of 20, 22 players from all the county around Paris, maximum 100 kilometers from the house. And we decide to educate this boy for 2 years in Clairefontaine. And we have had three targets very important. Why we took so young? Because it's always a danger to take the players very young. We decide to take first because we want first to protect the school, normal. The school was and is normal. And they train at the end of the day, 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon, with one special coach. he managed his session only around the individual technique. It's not to prepare the player to play the game. It's only to for the player to learn and to is able to have a great knowledge about the alphabet football. Alphabet football is the dummies, the control, the shoot, the head game, the weak foot, the dribble, everything. You need to know perfectly all these moves and after to have the good expression during the game. And the third option, very important, but not is only for the football. It's all the sports that suffer this when the coach and the federation, they decide to take the very young player. The danger is to break the affective life. And our target, it was to bring the boy from the Monday until the Friday evening. And the Friday evening, they go back in their family and they play in their own club. This during 2 years. And that it was very important to create this organization. But it was an organization from the federation. It's not to be owner of this player and to keep this player for the federation. It's not only to show this new method and to prepare very well the young players. And you imagine when for the coaches, special coaches, they work in this sort of the center, they have another philosophy than the coach from the academy or another philosophy of the coach of the first team. Why it was so important? Because it's different. They are very young. They are not prepared for the effort. In fact, during these 2 years, for them, it's a discovery about the future, a possible future. We don't know, but it's a possible future to have the access after, to go in the academy first and to be well prepared, and after to be professional. You need to know. And I was at the first group when we decided, because it was the first experience in France with the French FA, to recruit the young boy to organize with a group and to create a group with 20 players. I have practically potentially 40,000 boys around Paris in this county able to prepare and to come to do the test in Clairefontaine. And at the end, I took only 20. And in this 20, we have had William Gallas, Thierry Henry, Horten, many, many big players after they came. But it was very important in this period to select the boy and to detect quickly, the boy to have the capacity perhaps to try to be in the future professional. This experience, it was so fantastic because in 91, when I have this group with me, we imagine 7 years after we have had in the national team, winner of the World Cup in France in 98, Thierry Henry, he was inside this. Anelka, he was in the reserve. He was not in the group, but he was in the reserve. And quickly, many, many, many players, they came in the national team. We imagine the big jump they have had, but the most important, they came quickly and younger, but very well prepared. Very well prepared for the next level. And when the success was so important, my national technical director decided to create 11 new centers in France in between two counties and to create exactly the same model. And at the end of this organization, we are now practically 600 young boys each year. They come in this center. And now I think the total is 15 center and more. We create 9 for the girl. And we create at the bottom a fantastic capital about the young boy, but fantastic capital at the end in her head, the capital about the technique, because the huge and the fundamental idea, it was to develop and to increase the technique of the players. Why retaining the players? Because when everybody is fan of Ronaldo, of Messi, of Suarez, of many big players, no way the people are so admirative, so fantastic, so fun, because they have the fantastic technique. And the technique is so great, they change completely the life about the player. They have the great expression individually. They have the capacity to resolve the technical problem, to resolve the tactical problem. Last time, perhaps 2 months ago, I listened to the television, Thierry Henry. He talked about Claire Fontaine. And he said, I understood when I came in Barcelona, when I was close to me, Xavi and Iniesta, they play with me. I understood why I passed thousand and thousand times on the same situation tactically. Because I understood why I did this. I understood the situation, it was fantastic for me because I create and I grew quickly. And I grew quickly because I knew exactly what can I do when I need to keep the ball, when I need to pass, when I need to fix, when I need to dribble, because I have always in my head the situation where I, in Clairefontaine, I repeat and I repeat and I repeat and repeat. And the situation they were integrate about his game, and it was a great help for him. I say that was fantastic for my career. And that, no for Thierry Henry, because behind him, there are so many, many, many big players that came from Clairefontaine or another center for France. And the last is Mbappé. He came from this center. Our success, it was not an unselfish situation from the FA, because our effect, it was to open the eyes of the professional club, because at the start of the professional club, they were very worried. Oh, French FA, they took the best player. Now it's impossible. They took the best player for us and us. But when they understood the form and the attitude we have had inside of the session, totally different than you want to prepare the team the Sunday to play the game, they understood to create at the same time long time now, after perhaps all the French team in Premier League French, they have now inside the same group, 13, 15 years old, same distance from the house and the possibility all the weekend to go back in their family and to have the protection for the school, normal school, and at the same time, the special coach for the individual technique. The great result you have had, not in 98, but after we were in final, we are in quarterfinal, but in quarterfinal in the World Cup in Brazil, and after we were in the final for the European Cup when we lost against Portugal in Paris, and last time we won the World Cup in Russia. The observation you have had about all those 23 players, all the 23 players, they grew practically until the 16 or 17 years old, around their era, maximum 100 kilometers. Why is so important? When you have the young players, is to protect the affective life, to have the normal life, to have the contact with their family or their friends on Saturday or Sunday and to play in their club. And at the same time, to have the good evolution inside of the school and at the same time, the quality of the session. That was a fantastic success to get the great effort about the club and about the national team. Perhaps you can tell me, yes, but with the Champions League, French team, that is difficult. We never saw in the second round this and this. Yes, I agree with you. But the problem, we have lost 80 or 90 best players in France. We have lost perhaps 5 best teams at the top of the table. And the explanation is this. And all the best players, they leave the France. They leave the summer at the same time that explain you. First, for the tax. And secondly, for the attractive country for the football. England, Italy, or Spain, or Germany are more attractive than France, I understand. But we lost practically five best teams at the top of the table. And that, we can do nothing. But we are in good health. Because at the same time, the evolution not only about the work about the technique for the players, but all the chairman in France, they are not crazy. They know now. They understood the work. And they understood now it's a business. Because if you observe always the player when they are young and they want to sell, always it's a big money for the club. And it's a big protection at the same time. Why the evolution in the French football is this? But don't forget, I talk now for the practically to talk about the players. But it's impossible when you're the players. You need to have the good coach. And we create at the same time the school for the coach. And the school for the coach start, and we have the long time to have the good evolution and to obtain all the diploma. And that is another thing very important. It's the same. It's impossible to be professional coach if you don't go to the school or don't want to practice inside of the coach, of the instructor of the coach, and to help you and to educate you. That it was at the same time in parallel, at the same time together the evolution, players and the coach. And in the coach, we have had always. When you want to be coach, yes, you can be coach for the Premier League, be manager, yes. But the manager of the Premier League is not able to be a director of the academy. And the director of the academy, he's not able to be manager. At the same time, the coach for the very young players between 13 and 15 years old, he's not perhaps not able really to... We organize in our coach different level. With different content, and that different content to organize, it was organized for us to grow and to develop our system. And really, we have many specialists in each level. Example: when you go in for the academy, the director stay 5, 6, 7, 10 years. It's the same with the coach with the young players, because more you stay in this level, more you are good. More you improve your quality, more you know very well all the program inside. You know exactly how to manage. You know exactly how the reaction of the boy. The boy are totally different. The boy from 12 years or 13 years is totally different than 16 years. It's totally different than 20 years. It's totally different than 25 years. And why we push and you have the big selection about the coach. Big selection. And that was another evolution to have the possibility to for the players and for the coach to grow and to grow in very good condition. The practically the evolution in French football, it was this because France, if you observe the France between England or Italy or Spain, France it's a country for the game. England is a country for the effort. Italy is a country for the tactic, and perhaps more the Spain is able to mix both. And Germany, at the same time, is a big country for the effort, and it's a big evolution. Why? In this moment, we are in this position. The most important for us now is to maintain and to stay in this level. And I, after perhaps 20 years, and perhaps more, 30 years, we're able to stay in a three or four, five best place. Perhaps now we are in second place. We were before in first place. But the most important for us is to stay here. Why you stay here? Because everybody work very well. Everybody try to do the best. Everybody change. In 2010, Germany was in very difficulty after the African World Cup in South Africa. And they change. And they copy the French system. The Belgium, they change. And they copy the French. They're in second position. They want nothing, but they're in second position. They're in second position because they work very well for the young players. At the same time, the Portugal or the Swiss, And you can observe at the same time now, England, 2 years ago, they won everything. And 16 and 17 and 18 and 19, they five titles, fantastic, fantastic. The evolution is this now. The evolution is inside of the quality and the preparation of the young players. Perhaps I was a little bit long, but I want to explain a little bit the conception that we did. But really, I can tell you, very simple, very clear. Always great attitude, always great respect in everything, and after to believe in higher conviction. Only this. The exercise very simple, to repeat in great quantity. And when we observe the players, they grow, we put inside more and little bit more difficulties to push a player to go forward, always to push forward and to push forward, but slowly, slowly, and in front of the feedback with the player, with the group. You send the message and you understand very, you will understand very well. If your explanation is very good, all of the players are now good. You need to adapt always. That was our position about our football, and we try always to improve, to change, to modify, and but to put a big charge, because the high level doesn't accept the low level. The high level, it's always the great effort, the great attitude, and always great quality. And you have now, in fact, many big representatives for the France, as a coach, as a player, and why we can think how long way that we did, but I think we did, it was in a good way. It was not always easy. It was not always with a big result, but we have some moment difficult, but the quality of the bottom come always, always, always in great quantity. And when this quality great grew not only with the French FA, because the French FA, it's only the place to give the direction and the example and the method. And the professional club, no crazy, they understood, they did slowly the same thing. And the low pyramid that you have at the bottom, immediately with the French FA, and if you add all the professional club, you have the great foundation, and the bottom of the pyramid is very strong. And that was our idea, and the idea now to protect our football. Okay, Sean, I discussed a little bit long, but the idea is to present simple the situation.
That was perfect. So moving from that international youth environment, going to work as, you know, the coaches and assistants to managers in club level, obviously in England with Liverpool and Fulham, and in Italy when you worked there. How was that transition for you, having worked with youth players for a large part of your career?
No, my career, I started when I was very young. I was a coach at 25 years old. I was in a professional club, Premier League in France and Nice, and was player before. And after I was director of the Nice Academy Football, and I can tell you I have some big players, and one he was one of the big players. He came in England. He was Ginola, and after this period, when I was for 10 years in this place, I went to the French FA, and for practically 13 years. I work for the methodology in France, for the French Institute National French Football. And after, I was coach for the national team under 15, 16, 18. I won the European Cup in 96 with Thierry Henry, Trezeguet, Anelka, all this group, Sylvestre, all these players, Galas. And after I was in national team winner of the World Cup in 98, 99. And after I came in Nice in the academy, professional, and for 1 year I worked with the young players, and I took the first team for 6 months. For the first team was in the championship. And when I came in Fulham, I was coach and assistant manager of Gentigana. And at the same time, always and immediately, I went to support the academy in Fulham. Because in Fulham, we have a big squad, but really, at the level of the young of the academy, I would have to bring my support, and I bring all my support, and I teach a coach. Example, I teach a coach. You have one. He was no bad because he was Paul Clement. He was in Chelsea, and after he was assistant at Ancelotti, and I saw he was coach in Coventry and Cardiff. And at the same time, when I have the time, particularly each 2 weeks. I pass all the day with a coach to give all my exercise and to practice with them and to help. And the result was after 3 years, before you have no one, and after 3 years we have 11 international young players in Fulham. And we have some young players that came in first team after 3 years. When I was in Liverpool, it was a little bit different because we are in a situation very high. And we play the UEFA Cup, and we finish in third place. And I was in contact, but I was no big time to go. But when I came after in Fulham, I did again in Fulham, in Roma, always. I was not only coach or assistant for the first team. Always, I was behind to support the coaches in the academy, and at the same time to teach the young players and to help. And to help and to give the direction that I can do, and if I can add. It's important for the spirit of the club. If you have the people from the first team, they came back, it's important for the future. It's important for the coach. Everybody is very involved and is very aware who are behind and who try to help. That was always my idea. And I continue after when I came in China for 2 years. I was always to observe and to follow all the level of the young players and to give the direction and to help the coach. That is fundamental. You cannot care only the star players. Yes, I care the star players. I was with the big players. In Fulham, we have Louis Saha. He was a good player, but Michael Owen, Stevie Gerrard, and many big players in Liverpool. Oh, after in Southampton, BT and Peter Crouch, many be another big. Oh, in Fulham, in Juventus with Del Piero, Camoranesi, Nedved. We have six winners of the World Cup and one Golden Boy ball. And the same in Roma with Totti, De Rossi, and all these players. The same to care the big players, because when you want to win the game, you need to have the big players very in great form, because it's difficult to win.
You mentioned when you were at Liverpool, obviously the expectations at Liverpool were very different to the expectations at Fulham, and culture was very different, because obviously when you come in working with Gerard Houllier, it had always been the boot room before that with Liverpool connections to the coaching staff. How did you guys find adjusting that culture to a more global European mindset? Was that a challenge, or did you guys kind of work with the players on that and find that they were really receptive to it?
You need when you're in Fulham, it's totally different than you are in Liverpool. The target is different. Even you want to be the best in Fulham, but you don't have the same means. You have the same quality about the players, and the level is different. And it's it. And when you are in the big club, you need only to care more the big players, because the difference is done by the big players, and it's a big difficulty for the coach, and the expectation. When you are in Liverpool, it's massive, because the people, they wait you only in the first place or second place, third place. They don't accept the very bad position. It's for the short time, perhaps, but no long time. That is a big difficulty for the job. when you're in the big club is to maintain always a team in the top one, two, three, or four. After is difficult.
In terms of the coach, you mentioned obviously supporting the coaches and the
coaches. Pardon, I difficult to listen. Pardon.
You mentioned supporting the coaches a lot, and obviously Paul Clement was a good example. Have you seen a big shift in the quality and engagement of coaches, obviously, since you've been involved in the game, in terms of that support that coaches now have, in terms of, I guess, qualifications, learning experiences and resources, instead outside of just one person having to give their experience?
The Russian, that I have with, in the club with the coaches?
Yeah.
You say, you ask? Yes. No, I mean, the Russian, we need to create this, because we are inside the same club. You need to give the best. You need to give everything. You need to hide nothing. You need to help the people. When I was in Fulham, I can tell you, after 6 months, you have the very bad situation with the Coleman. Chris Coleman, he had the big car crash. And he, for the players, it was finished. And me, I asked immediately to Jean Tigana and the chairman, please, I would like to take him with me to be assistant. And I teach him. I teach him for 3 years. And Chris Coleman, he was with me every day. And I give the best, always we explain the methodology, this and this and this. In every pass, when I pass, always I try to give it. I have not the through. It's not the through in the life, but it's a conviction. And at the same time, you come with our experience, we have the background, and you try always to impress the people. Because when you pass, it's good to pass, but you need to leave many things for the people that are inside. And the people, they wait. And at the same time, you create a very good spirit with everybody.
When you worked with, obviously, a lot of the youth players in France, and you mentioned that there was 20,000 to get down to 40, what was the most important attribute that you saw in the players that were successful? Was it that they were the most highly skilled? Was it that they were the most mentally strong, mentally focused? Was there something that you, as a coach, determined that was more to help the players be successful, you know?
Alors, the French footballer, when he's young, is weak. He's weak mental, no discipline. French people, the discipline is a little bit difficult. And but at the same time, another side, they're great. They try to try some things different, they try. Secondly, they need to learn. And when you want to learn football, it's easy because it's a passion. It's a passion for the coach, but it's a passion for the players. And we play on this. The passion of this football for the boys, it has a great influence about the school, about the attitude, about the family, about the friend. It's a big support to educate. French player is like this. Is always discipline is difficult, and we create this. We create inside the discipline, with a strict attitude, with a great education, with a great respect. In England, that is not necessarily because the people are like this. They accept. They are normal. They in France totally different. We build this. In England, you are born like this. It's normal. In France, I repeat, that you repeat and you think, today it's okay, they understood. Next day, again, you restart. The big difficulty is this in France. But we create this with a special coach. The people are able to first to educate very well the people for the simple thing. Not only to educate for the tactic and this. To educate for the simple thing, for thanks, pardon, hello, please, to respect the gardener, to respect the people that prepare the food, to respect everything. And you are in this position first. And after, progressively inside, you have the possibility to educate very well the player. As a French player, he has this quality. He has quality when he understands, and he can do this, and more this, or this, and this, and this, and this. Yes, you have another player. The difference is this, but the difference, because a French coach and our education with a coach, we decide to do this. we stay in strong and strong discipline, but at the same time to push a little bit the creativity of the players. And the big difference for me was this. And why I do it, why is this? Because progressively, more the player is master of his technique, like everybody in their job, you have automatically the capacity to have the good expression, to be master, to be to have a very good attitude, to stay calm, and to have the capacity to find the solution. Because during the session, you repeat, and inside of your life of the football, you have the people that push you in this direction. That is different. Why the French football? If you observe the French footballer, you can find in every part in Europe, in every part, he's able to adapt very well. He's able to, perhaps sometimes a little bit lack of discipline, but the rest, they're able to have the expression during the game. And we do, and we did, because when we start long time ago, the big problem was the example in front of the English football. It was a physical contact. We are unable to contact, to fight. We are too low, no strong. And that we work this sort of the attitude. We work physically, we work more physically. And we create between 16 and 19 years old, not only footballer, but the athlete. Football is athlete first. If you're not able to run, to jump, and to take the speed, it's difficult to play.
Did you find that back, I guess in those early days, it was the players came to you with a stronger technical foundation because of the culture of, like you said, France is a football country, UK, Italy, Germany, they're football countries where the players play a lot in their own time. So they kind of did a lot of their own technical training outside of having to do it, repeating individual isolated technical training. So you were able to kickstart earlier in the creativity and the decision-making side? Or was it something that you guys really focused on still at that young age where lots of technical repetitions, you know, isolated work without opponents? How did that look? And how do you think that's changed as football and culture, I guess, has developed?
No, but the best development when you have a young player, but in each sport, not only in football, it's between 12 and 15 years, about the ability and about the capacity to for the player to do the right move, because they don't have the bad habit. They start. You need to respect first. When they start to play football, like us, we start. We'll play 5 years old until 10 or 12 years old. They need to play. Don't put the pressure. It's not important to win, to lose. It's not important. It's the most important to play, to have the pleasure, to be enjoy. That you explain is a fantastic expression in England. To be enjoy. Yes, to be enjoy. Go to play football. I enjoy it with my friend. But when you start at 12 years old, it's a moment where about your physiology change and all the nervous system is ready to prepare and to accept more easy different move. The dummies is fundamental. The control, but not only when I am static, when I move, and when I run, when I jump. And that is a moment to develop for the young boys this sort of the attitude. And to have, after, this familiarity with the ball, to touch the ball, to develop the sensibility with the feet. To play football is not normal, because with the feet it's difficult. It's more easy with the hand. Why some people, they start with the rugby at 16 years old, they're international. Footballer at 16 years old, finish. No chance. And why we try to develop? We try to develop and to develop the sensibility of the players. Not only the sensibility of the player, the capacity to reduce the speed with the control with the ball. If you observe one boy, he controls the ball 12 years old, we send the ball 12 years old, he's a big hesitation. I go and don't go. When you saw the prep, after eight years to work or 6 years to work, if you observe the players are 20 years old, and when they play the football, the ball is thick and he can use the ball easily. With one control, one touch. But to reduce this time For the contact with the ball, it's only the repetition. But the repetition in good condition, the repetition in a tactical position, because it's not only in front of the wall or in front of my friend, it's in front of the zone with different position, and I need to repeat all this move. And inside, I have all this technical skill to repeat, and the quantity of the repetition to increase automatically your quality. But
Did you find it was one of the biggest things that you did by having the players come to Clairefontaine was creating that environment where there was like players with a similar mental strength and focus to be able to compete and push each other? So as that part of it, the coaches, that job was done for you because you had players with the right mentality there and you guys had to just focus on fine-tuning the skills, fine-tuning the decisions, the speed of processing the information instead of having to also focus too much on developing that mental skill set that we talked about previously.
No, man, I think when you train, everything is linked. You cannot think I train because I want to develop only the physique now. Why? The quality of the coach is very important. Because you need to mix. The technical work is fundamental. But when I work technically, I need to know why I do this move and where on the pitch. And that is linked as the tactic. And after when I link this as the tactic, I link this with the physique. Because I can run slowly, but I can run quickly. When I need to jump, when I need to move, when I need to start to go and forth, and to move for the coordination. And at the same time, my spirit. Because in my spirit, it grows in front of the success of my technique. More I fail with the control and with the pass, more I am able to play very well. And perhaps I need to work a little bit slowly and to have more success. Why? The coach, I need to organize the exercise special in front of the players and to help to have the possibility to have the good success. Approximately on 10 ball, or 10 ball we play, perhaps minimum 6 good control, 6 good balls. That is important. It's important because it gives you a comfortable spirit because, oh, I am able. I am not very able, but I am able. I can do. But if you can do and to create and to reinforce and to consolidate this situation, you automatically your spirit follows the situation because I want to have the success. When you work, I work with many times with the big star players in front of one against one. And always I put the big difficulty. And always say, oh, I able? Are you able? They are furious. They are furious, not against me, against them, because they want to have the success. They want to always have the success. And if they don't have the success, they repeat until the time to have the success. And that, to create this, it's the quality of the session. The session, it's always a place, no, yes, the fun, the good spirit, the good relation, but after inside, the great quality inside of it. The great quality and always, the great quality inside, but very organized in front of the level of the players. I cannot give the simple exercise very for the school of the boy, 6 or 7 years old, for the star players. And that I cannot give the exercise from the star players, I'm a one player for 12 years old. He tell me, oh, that is impossible for me. It's like in the school. Cannot have the same exercise from the university if I am only in the primary school. And the same, and the opposite is the same. The problem after is the quality of the coach. And that is a very important that we did and we do to develop this coach in this direction.
When we talk about coach development, what is the pathway like for coaches in France at the moment? Obviously, in Europe, we see a lot more former professionals who become coaches at high level and even at academy level. Obviously, in the rest of the world, here in the US, there's a lot of players who maybe didn't play at the top level who are able to coach at a professional or academy level. But what does that look like in France? What's the pathway for a coach to become a higher level coach in France?
Totally. You have one example in France, two examples, perhaps more, three or four. It's Zidane, Deschamps. But they were big before, and immediately they have the success, like Laurent Blanc. They have a success when they came coaches. But that is some exception, because the most of the coach in Premier League in France, they come from the, not for the bottom, but they have different experience for the amateur level, for the different level. They grow because it's a special job. It's a job nobody is certain to have the win, but the experience of everybody is very important. That is very important. That experience, if you observe now in France, it's a case. We don't have the many big, big ex-players, but we have many coaches very involved about all the problem inside of the football, and they are master about the situation. And they grow like this, and they grow like this.
And there was a lot of, obviously not too long ago, there was some conversations about the development of players in and around Paris, where a number of the players that developed all around the same time played in the inner city, in the suburbs, and in kind of those cage football games, street football. They didn't actually play in a structured environment, but they got their grounded in that unstructured environment where they weren't being, I guess, coached or overcoached. Did you see that as being a trend in some of the players that came to you? I know Thierry Henry was a kid who came from that kind of environment. Did you see a difference in those players who had, I guess, learned football on the streets in that kind of rougher, tougher environment?
Oh, there is one thing fundamental, but it's not only in Paris and the suburb. The football grew and they come only for the low level about the society. Football is like the box, and always is in this atmosphere. The players they come from this place. After, yes, perhaps in some place they have the possibility to play football in the land, and to, yes, but that is more difficult now to find this. In every part now, it's difficult for the young to play alone, free in the field, and that we can see in your country, in your park, and in every part is fantastic, because the players play under the rain with grass, without grass, they play. In France, it's not the case, and we create it. It's a little bit difficulty for us. Yes, it's a little bit difficulty for us, and it's all. We don't have many another solution now. It's a little bit handicap. Yes.
If you have, obviously the structure is a lot different from the US and in other countries, but you have a situation where coaches are developing young players to win. And like I said, the aim in the long term is to prepare and promote players to play for first teams and national teams within academy structures. But do you see coaches being judged on their win-loss record as much as that part? Because obviously we know at the top level there's a great deal of pressure on managers to win games. But do you find that filtering down into youth coaching in France at all, or across Europe as you were there? So coaches maybe aren't given the amount of time and patience that they may need to truly develop players for that higher level. Is that something you've experienced at all?
Yes, I agree with you. That is, I can tell you, is the part more difficult for the coach. But if I come back, as I explained before, with a young boy under 12 years old, 13, 15, and more, during their education, the coach has a very great impact about this work. Because every time, when the coach proposed one exercise, it's not the exercise for the exercise. It's a one exercise with a success. And if you want to build the win and you want to build the success, start from the exercise during each session. And when you start to create this, but no, don't put the pressure. But if I ask to play 10 times on this place, and it, perhaps it's an easy ball to play, and if the success is 8 or 9 times, very interesting. But if it's low, you need to put the pressure for this moment. Perhaps to reduce the speed, to reduce the distance, to cancel some exercise, something details inside of the exercise to complicate, but put always the player in front to have the success. Each time he do something, he need to do with a success, or 80 or 90%. And you create easily, from 12 years old, this situation to be a winner and to be. Yes, you have some player, perhaps they're not ready for the competition, or perhaps in the future, they will not play competition because they are not really, they don't understand really the importance of this. But most of the players, and I can tell you immediately, they understand quickly the importance about this efficacy. It's fundamental. And you create three. You don't need the Sunday to play, hey, come on, come on, come on, or to shout on the player. No. If you prepare very well the player during the week, the Sunday, your game is not complicated. Yes, you can lose, but I can tell you. If you lost, they are very strong the others when they won. I can tell you. But that's important for the player. Don't put the pressure about the result. Put the pressure about the quality. Put the pressure about to be concentrated about the game. Not about the result. About the game. More you play well, more you will win. More you play bad, it's more difficult to win, I can tell you. You can win sometimes, but it's lucky.
That comes a lot from, like you mentioned before, the training environment. If you're doing 1v1s, the players want to be competitive against each other. They want to be successful against each other. So that develops that competition of wanting to win, that then they take into the game without you having to, you know, like you said, shout with the players to go, 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 win. We have to score because you've created that environment in training without the pressure of the game on the side of it. Does that make sense?
Yes. I think in this age, it's more important to develop the individual technique than to develop the single and to fight and this and this. Because you can fight together. But if my technique is no good, I no chance. I no chance. Yes, if you have a good technique, you will win every time. That was the problem. It's to fight because I'm not strong in my head. No, not in my head. It's my feet. My feet are so weak. First, I need to build with my feet the technique, and after I can fight you. But before, no. Yes, you can do to try sometime. But you need to give the player the possibility to be strong and to have, to be master with this technique. If you are not master with the technique, finish. I can tell you simple thing. Tomorrow, when you want to train a team and you want to play a game, and I tell you always to the coach, when you want to get a game with a young boys, it's not complicated. First, when the opponent has a ball, I press immediately. I press. Why I press? Because the technique is so weak, I lost the ball immediately. Secondly, what can I do when I have the ball? I prepare me very well during my session with the technique. If I press quickly as I lose the ball and I play with my technique, what is the problem? No problem. Simple, very simple. But you need to be very concrete with the players and they need to understand this. If you observe the player, when the distance 3 or 4 meters are no problem. When the opponent he has 1 meter or less than 1 meter, finish. Big trouble. They lost the ball. They don't understand the, what can I do. If you are not prepared technically, you lost the ball.
In order to achieve that from the training perspective, did you, like I said, train technique in isolation? So one player without any opponent, just I guess, manipulate the size of your activity to make it more successful for them. But like you said, in a game, you can have 3 or 4 meters and you'll be fine. But if you only have 2 meters, it's much more difficult because you're under that immediate pressure and your technique is still learning it and it's still not perfect. Would you have them do the same activity but in a bigger space, so it allows them to work on that technique? And then as they get better, you make the space smaller and smaller, so they become under more and more pressure, but their technique has improved because of the success they had in the bigger space? Or would you do individual skill building, ball mastery, Korver style work that you also encourage them to do at home? How would you guys have managed kind of that at the initial foundation phase of development?
To manage is always the same. You are in front of the players, and in front of the players, when you are 20 players, you don't have the 20 same players. You have perhaps 2 or 3 very good players. You have the group of 10 or 15 average players, and you have 3 or 4 players weak. That is a group. All the group is like this. But you need to consider always, when you propose something to the group, to the players, to have the good success inside. And when you start with a player, in total they are weak, you need to work empty without opponent. Simple. The relation player and ball. And to create this. And sometimes you can do something. But first, to allow the player to increase slowly and slowly without opponent and to be master with the ball. And progressively, after, I can try to put some difficulty inside. And that is the evolution. Always I start from the simple exercise and with evolution and difficulties in front of the answer of the players. In front of the answer of the players. And that is important because if you want to, it's like in the school. When they give you the exercise where you're able to manage and at 90 or 80%, you have the good result. You are strong. You have the confidence with you. But when they give you the exercise, you fail 1, 2, 3, 4. And in total, you fail for, 60 or 70%. It's not because you are lazy, because you said, it's too difficult for me. I am not prepared for this. And I lost, and I took my distance for the exercise. And I am not inside, because it's too difficult. And you accept. And why the position for the coach is so important to always to stay at the level of the people in front. You cannot do the same exercise from Liverpool first team with a young boy, 12 years old. It's not, yes, it's beautiful to do this because they do this. No chance. No chance. The result is a disaster. And you need always, and I repeat always, the quality of the coach is fundamental. Because it's him to give you the impulse and to help you or to reduce and to push on it. I can tell you, for the young players, but for the top players, the same. Huh? Sometimes I was in front of the big players, meaning big difficulties. In big difficulties, I want to help to have the success in something. And restart with some exercise, so simple. I can tell you, sometimes I went behind the edge when we were alone, both. To repeat because he was so in difficulty in front of the other, he doesn't want to work. And we create at the same time this sensibility with the technique, but the confidence. And slowly and slowly and slowly and slowly he restart, he came back because he's strong. And after you can ask him the exceptional move because he's able to do the exceptional move. But everybody has his problem. And for the players, the same. And why the technique, and why we put many times the accent, the technique is fundamental at the start. And we link everything around.
Obviously, we mentioned the coaches paramount. When you went through and you coached some of these big players who have now become big managers, were there any of these players who, when you were working with them as a player, stood out as people or players or just, again, people who you thought were going to go on and become coaches? Obviously, we have Deschamps, as you mentioned, and Zinedine Zidane, and Steven Gerrard now is managing as well and coaching. Was there anything that you recognised in those players you worked with that you felt would go on to become top quality coaches because of their the way they worked, I guess, when they were players, and their engagement in the game as a whole, I guess.
I mean, I think when these players, they have so big career, the fantastic players, and where they're brave and they're able to inform the players and to cancel, in fact, their career. They don't talk about their career. They're able to put on the level of these players because they're different. They don't have the same players like Zidane or Sylvie Gérard or many other players. So many times I said, you was player, okay, now change your skin. Change your skin now. Your skin is coach, totally different. You start from zero. Don't forget your career. Don't take you, say, me, I did this. No, no, no way. They know very well. And this big fan or admiration about the players with the coach is for 2 weeks' time. If they lose of the game, finish. Yeah? the admiration is finished, yeah? Because the players, they want to win. And the most difficult for the big players is to be able to forget the players in front of him. They don't have the same ability of them. And they need to accept. They need to accept the error. They need to accept the fail. They need to accept they did a bad game. And they need to push. They need to find the solution. They need to find the solution. Perhaps never they were in this situation. But that is a problem when you're a coach. We need to find the solution for the player. What we can do? What we can do? What can I do for him? You can't tell, no, me, I am able to do, you can do the same. No, everybody is different. It's a big big quality example for sure, for Stevie Gérard, or Zinedine Zidane, or Didier Deschamps. They have this big support. They are fantastic people behind. They never put in difficulty, they try always to help. Try to help to give a solution to discuss that it's very important for those players because their career is one thing, but coach is another thing, totally different. Example at the end, it's one when you are coach, when you are a player, you are a very selfish man, and when you are coach, it's an opposite totally. You live only for the group. You live only for the collectivity. You live only for the players. You sacrifice your position. You can lose the job for them. When your player is nothing, it's not this. When your player is only himself. Stop. Big change. And that some big players are able to do, some they're not able. It's life. It's personal.
We've seen, I guess, not a shift necessarily, but much more of a focus on the managers who develop very strong personal relationships with their players, it seems, from the outside. Managers like, Jurgen Klopp, Pep Guardiola, those guys are now at the top end of the managing game, and everyone's looking at it as which part is more important, the tactics or the personal relationship and the development of culture. Obviously, you've worked with a number of managers. Which part did you find to always be the most important in terms of relationships with the players or just the cold?
No, I think you took two big examples. Guardiola, he has a big method. He has a great relation with the players, but he creates a special spirit to play tactically. And it's an example, but it's not an example, Guardiola. Guardiola is an example, fantastic. Everybody loves Barcelona with Guardiola. Everybody loves Guardiola with Manchester City. Everybody wants to be like Barcelona, but in fact, at the end, they remain only one Barcelona or only Manchester City. It's from Guardiola because he has the players. He educates the players in this direction. It's the big philosophy, the big methodology. And everybody dreams. But to be able To have the possession ball, it's a big dream, I can tell you. Because to have possession ball, you need to have the big technique. If you don't do big technique, no chance. But at the end, in the penalty box, you need to have the men to score. Because you can have the possession ball. At the end, you have nothing. Example, Spain, in Russia, many teams like Spain and many teams have a good possession ball as they didn't have the result. And at the same time, Klopp, he has a big adaptation with the players. He has a great spirit, great relation, great confidence with the players. The players have confidence. He creates this fantastic spirit. And at the end, he has a result. The result changes life. When you don't have the result, in another way. Guardiola, he can play very well this year. He has no chance. He play very well. Can say he play very well. And at the end, he's in a situation. And Klopp, fantastic. Everything was good. Everything is good. After the job, at the end, it's the chance. You need to be a little bit lucky. If you're not lucky, it's difficult to win. But football is this. Football is, when you're on this level, for the manager, it's a capacity to give the big importance about the players, the big players, and after it's the players to give you back. Because the players have confidence with you and give you back the solution easily during the game. That is important.
We talk about the big French players. A lot of those bigger French players left the French league pretty young. They didn't stay and play in the French league for a large part of their career. Do you think that's been something that's been beneficial to the development of younger players because they've had more opportunities to play higher level Ligue 1, Ligue 2 football earlier than maybe in countries like England, who brings in a lot of French players, or Italy and Germany, where they bring in a lot of foreign players to their leagues. So sometimes their younger players can be prevented from getting opportunities.
I agree with you. It's a very good remark. The French player, he has a fantastic opportunity to be promoted. Because when you lost, every time many players they go away, you're the place. You're the place in Premier League. On opposite side, when you're in England, where's the place? You have so many foreign players. You have all the best foreign player in your country. If you observe 80 or 90% for the top five team, foreign. At the same time, the coaches. And it's difficult. The space, no space. It's no space. And one thing important, but in every part, when you prepare somebody, when you prepare the student, when you prepare this, it's not only to prepare to obtain the result and to obtain the qualification. It's to be promoted. It is to be able to go in this level, to prepare and to be prepared. And in France, that is fantastic because every time you are losing the players and every time you have the space for the young player, and quickly they mature and they are ready to go away. I agree with you.
Yep. It's a good challenge to have for a country that uses a lot of players. It gives them a chance to give players opportunities. So that's beneficial to everyone. I have a question from Lee who's asked, it's becoming more common for children to enter academies at a very young age. You know, some cases, six-year-olds are joining academies. Do you think this is beneficial? Or should these kids be able to learn in that street environment that we talked about? And so, you know, obviously Bayern Munich are one club that's removed their start point for their academy to an older age. But should we be looking at having kids just play more? Or is that, again, a nature of current society where kids don't play more anymore? Instead, they play video games or they watch TV. Instead of going out and playing in the park, so having them in an academy is the best environment for them because they're able to play, even if it's in a more structured environment.
Problem, if you don't have the possibility to go in the street, you are very happy to go in the academy. After in the academy, of this young age that you explain, they need to go to play and to play for the fun. You cannot start to do this, now organize some game, organize a little bit small work, technical work. They need to smile, to to cry. They need to have some emotion, simple, of the football. They need to, because in fact, it's a discovery. It's impossible to say a 6 or 7 or 8 years old, this player will be professional. Impossible, impossible. There are so many steps in the middle. Not only physically, but on the point, mental point. He has so many uncertain situations. And why, at the start, the young boy need to play and to play for the fun. It's not no pressure. If you can play more in the street, it's good. But the place now in the street is very, very limited.
One last question for you, Christian. If you were to give one piece of advice to young aspiring coaches, or even young coaches who are really looking to improve, develop their craft, what piece of advice would that be to give them as they move forward?
Pardon, I don't listen very well to the question, excuse me.
If you had one piece of advice to give to young or aspiring coaches who either want to work at a higher level or just really want to improve and develop their coaching, what piece of advice would that be?
I mean, really, when you are in front of the young boys and to educate this, I think you need to have this passion, to like to work with the boys, because it's a special job. It's a special job. It's not easy, and it's many times on the shed. It's not like when you work on with the first team, with a big crowd, with television, this and this. But another side, for the coach, I can tell you, put your passion, give your best, try to give everything, and to wait nothing, because at the end, you will be never disappointed. That is my idea when you are with young. It's like when you are parents, the same. You need to give the best, to help the maximum, and wait and see. But that is it. But the passion and the want to work with a young boy, it's special. That is special. And that is inside of your heart and inside of you.
Well, Christian, we really appreciate you joining us today. This was a great insight into both development of the French player and just overall general development in terms of a professional environment. So thank you for taking the time to join us today. And thank you all for joining us as well. Any questions for Christian, feel free to reach out to me and I can pass them on to him if we didn't get to them today. But again, from me, Christian, just a huge thank you for taking the time to join us today.
Thank you, Sean. Thank you. It was a great pleasure to speak about my football. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye all.
Okay. All right.